Just as we've said before, it's very important. Before you can clear an exponent, it must first be alone. Just like when we had radicals and we had to get them alone before we could do anything to them. Same for exponents. They have to be alone. So in example 1, we have 4 minus 2 times the quantity 2x plus 1 squared equals negative 46. We can't do anything to that exponent stuff until we get it by itself. So we have to continue to keep our equation balanced by first subtracting 4 from both sides. And that gives us negative 2 times the quantity 2x plus 1 squared equals negative 50. Now, we can divide by 2 on both sides. Take that back, negative 2 on both sides. This gives me what's in parentheses and the exponent. That's what I was trying to do. So I'm going to have 2x plus 1 raised to the second power equals 25. Now remember, I can take the square root of both sides. When I take the square root of both sides, I have to allow for both my positive and negative solutions. I've undone that exponent, so the 2x plus 1 drops out equals plus or minus square root of 25. So I get 2x plus 1 is equal to plus or minus 5. Now I need to solve for x. I'll subtract 1 from both sides, and that gives me 2x is equal to negative 1 plus or minus 5. Now I get to divide by 2 to get x by itself. So x is equal to negative 1 plus or minus 5 divided by 2. Now we have to find those two values. X can equal, if we take the positive 5 option, we'll have negative 1 plus 5, which is 4 halves, or just 2. And then the other option would be if 5 was negative, and that would be negative 6 over 2. So since these fractions can be reduced, I'll have x is equal to 2 or negative 3. In example 2, I'm going to follow the same process again. First, I'm going to subtract 6 from both sides. Now I have 5 times 3x minus 2 squared equals 40. Now I'm going to divide by 5 to get that exponent by itself. Now I have 3x minus 2 squared equals 8. Now to clear that exponent, I take the square root of both sides. And I have 3x minus 2 that drops out equals 2 root 2. And remember, it has to be plus or minus since I took an even root. Now, I'm going to add 2 to both sides. That gives me 3x is equal to 2 plus or minus 2 root 2. Dividing by 3 to isolate x, I now have x is equal to 2 plus or minus 2 root 2 over 3. Since there are no common factors that can be reduced between 2 and 3 and 2 root 2 and 3, I have nothing else I can do to this. It's in its most simplified form. So I'm done. That's my solution, and this is my solution.